What hasn't been said today is thank you. And look into the camera and say thank you to all the teachers that do educate our children in the public school system, to the cuts that they're going to have to face in the schools, and to those that are laying off. And as my Republicans moan and groan over there, I do respect what you do every single day, especially in tough urban school districts like mine. It matters, and some of you aren't going to have jobs. It's folks like Chris. Chris teaches at the West Mifflin Area School District. Chris and another 47 teachers are going to be laid off because of these budget cuts, either the new Republican proposed cut or the governor's old cut. Chris is 28 years old. He just had two kids and bought a brand new house in Westmoreland County in North Huntington. Chris wanted to start a great way of life. These are the faces of the people you're laying off. You're not laying off the union presidents, folks. You're not going to go get them. You're laying off folks that are in their late 20s and early 30s that tried to stay at home, tried to teach the kids many of the times at the same schools that they attended themselves and cared about Pennsylvania. When you or anybody else talks about brain drain, or when you and anybody else talks about unemployment, if the numbers go up next month, you're right, because you caused it. If my local school board raises taxes, I'm going to thank the governor and any single person that's elected that votes for this. This is devastating. So get your pens out. Chairman Adolph, I wrote you a letter. You responded. Thank you very much for being so professional about this. In the Republican proposed budget, $6.3 million was allocated for the Duquesne City School District. Remember the number 6.3. So I called their business manager to have a very frank discussion. Representative, the majority leader talked about responsibilities for children. I hope he's listening. So I said to the business manager, what are your costs this year? Well, he said, Representative Gergely, $1.6 million goes to the bond obligation prior to me having this position. $2.6 million goes to tuition reimbursements because we don't have a high school and we have to pay for those kids to go to other schools. And Representative, $2 million has to go to charter school reimbursements because there's no money that's included in this budget to offset that cost. And by the way, Representative, $500,000 has to go to state mandated transportation to special education children, which we feel we're obligated to pay and want to pay. Well, folks, if you had a pen out, if you're good at math, that's $6.7 million. 6.7. We allocated through the Republican budget 6.3. They're bankrupt. They're $400,000 in the hole because of this budget, and you're not educating a single kid. So when you put up this vote and you act so committed to wanting to do right for everybody, remember you just bankrupted a school district and every kid in that school. Maybe you care, maybe you don't. I get the impression you really don't care. I really do care. I care about the kids. Before I care about the teachers, before I care about anybody else, it's the kids that you aren't providing for an education. But hey, I'm not like the North Allegheny School District where my big budget cut was $97 per student. The Duquesne City School District was $2,000 per student. I'm not like the North Allegheny School District where my average salary for my teacher is over $71,000. My Duquesne teacher, who puts on their bootstraps every day to teach his hard district, makes a whopping $56,000. I wish I lived in a more rich area because I could get up on a microphone and tout how great this budget is. But folks, the reality is you're killing schools. You're killing schools every day. And I wasn't kidding. I talked to prominent folks in Clareton about their school district. They want to shut it down. They want to shut down their high school, and they want to send their kids who they feel are morally obligated to affluent school districts so they get an education. So I want to say again, do the right thing. Think about your outcomes. Think about kids in broke school districts, because folks, this isn't the end. You're going to vote for Duquesne. This budget's coming back. I need $3 million to run that school. So whether or not you believe it, you on that side, us on this side, someone's going to have to vote yes to fund Duquesne, and that isn't about good fiscal responsibility, because you haven't funded them now. They're not the only ones. Next year, there'll be more. There'll be Stowe Rocks. There'll be Clareton. There'll be Chester Upland. The list keeps on growing and growing. Failing schools will keep on happening. Do the right thing. Thank you.